Pope.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming?
Can you believe these people are protesting our national anthem? I wonder how people can even protest this song. Some claim that their protest is for oppression, police brutality, the criminal justice system, or even the third verse of the anthem. If you look back to the War of 1812, and particularly the Battle of Baltimore, you will realize that Francis Scott Key's thoughts became a poem, a song, a flag, our national anthem, and had absolutely nothing to do with today's protests. Maybe they're protesting Francis Scott Key's negotiated release of the American surgeon held prisoner by the British, or the victory of the Battle of Baltimore at Fort McHenry. Or maybe they're protesting Key's thoughts that morning on September 14, 1814, which later became a song composed by John Stafford Smith, or the 5 million signatures the veterans of foreign wars had on their petition for the national anthem. No matter how I look at it, I realize that none of these protests have anything to do with our anthem, but merely show disrespect to our veterans, their families, and our country. Title 36, Section 301 of the United States Code states that during a rendition of the national anthem, when the flag is displayed, all present, including those in uniform, should stand at attention. The law further provides that when the flag is not displayed, all present should face toward the music and act in the same manner they would if the flag were displayed. Unfortunately, the code is never enforced and there's no punishment for breaching it. Nearly every one of us is related to a veteran or knows one. Some of us even know a lot of veterans. If it's one thing we veterans hold value on, it's our flag. It symbolizes sacrifice, freedom, our nation, not to mention Remington Arms, Ford Trucks, and apple pie. Folks have been wounded both physically and mentally and have even been killed protecting this flag and what it represents. So if you're going to protest, protest the issue at hand and not let your fight get off track in order to make an even bigger issue with no meaning. There are way too many misguided individuals out there looking for their 5 minutes of fame.
1862, the song Tattoo came upon General Butterfield, and he adjusted some of the music, wrote it down. Later he asked Oliver W. Norton, the brigade bugler, to play the alteration of Tattoo. Butterfield again adjusted the melody by making some notes longer and shorter. The new melody quickly became known, the new call for Lights Out. Shortly after, other brigades heard this call and began to adapt it as their own and ask for the music. The sensation of taps became so widely used that Confederate buglers began to use the call. Taps was first played at a funeral for a cannoneer killed in action in the Civil War. Head of artillery and Union Captain John Tidball asked for taps instead of the traditional three-volley fires so that their position wouldn't be given away to the Confederates. 10 months after Taps was composed, it was played at General Stonewall Jackson's funeral. Taps did not receive its name until after the Civil War. Taps is now a requirement to be played at military funeral services.